emphasis for the month of June is joy. And so with that in mind, today I want to talk about when the joy is gone. Amen. When the joy is gone. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. When the joy is gone. This text, this psalm is another psalm of David. As we look at it at the time of the text, we see that David is writing a psalm telling us of a prayer of repentance that he had prayed unto God. For we know that there was a time in David's life when David had joy. No matter what difficulties he encountered, David had the Lord's joy in his life. This joy that David had is an invisible strength and delight that does not come from position. It does not come from any people. It does not come by having material possessions. But the joy that David had only comes from the Lord. The joy of the Lord is a joy that every believer can have through Jesus Christ. Nehemiah 8:10 tells us that the joy of the Lord is our strength. So, brothers and sisters, there was a time when David had the joy of the Lord in his life. And listen, I'm going to know, is there anybody here this morning that could use a burst of joy in your life? The kind of joy that I'm talking about is not a joy that comes from things. I'm not talking about a joy from a car. I'm not talking about the joy of having money. I'm not talking about the joy of having a boyfriend or a girlfriend. I'm not talking about joy in a house, because these things cannot give you true joy. Think about it. If your car is your joy, then what's going to happen if it gets wrecked? If your money is your joy, what you going to have when you run out? If your friend, your boyfriend or girlfriend is your joy, what you going to do when they don't want you anymore? So the joy that I'm talking is a joy that only comes from the Lord. It's a joy that only can be found in Jesus Christ. Now, I'm not talking about happiness, because happiness is something that you have based upon what happened. In other words, if the happening was good, that can make you happy. But if the happening was bad, it can make you unhappy. Happiness is something that you have based upon what happens externally. But joy is something that you have on the inside, regardless of what happens on the outside. It's the joy of the Lord. David had God's joy. David knew what it was like to have the joy of the Lord in one's life. It's a joy that will provide you strength even when others think you can't go on. It's a joy that will cause you to praise God even when things don't look good for you. Are you listening to me? It's a joy that'll make you when others are upset. It's a joy, brothers and sisters, that can cause you to rejoice in God. Even if you're behind on your bill and don't have the money to pay them and don't know where the money is going to come from. But you can have joy because you know that the silver and the gold belongs to God. And that some way, somehow, God is going to get you through. That's the kind of joy that I'm talking about. It's the joy that David had. But the text, Psalm 51, tells me that at some point David had lost his joy. That was a time when David's joy had disappeared. When David's joy was gone. Look at it. He was the king, but his joy was gone. He had plenty of money, but his joy was gone. He had a lot of followers, but his joy was gone. He had many accomplishments, but his joy was gone. He had experienced success over and over again. But that was a time, even in spite of his success, that David's joy was missing. Oh, my brothers and sisters, there might be somebody here this morning like David. Yes, look like everything is going for you externally. But internally, you know that your joy is missing. You're living a joyless life. There's no joy in your life. Perhaps there are some of you who used to have this joy, but this joy has evaporated, has disappeared from your life. Yes, it's just as if the joy has moved out without giving you a notice. Yes, my brothers and sisters, well, I want you to know here today, if you never had the Lord's joy, you can have it today, because this joy can be found in Jesus Christ. All you have to do is accept the Lord in your heart. God will be glad to give you his joy. Now, if you once had it and somewhere along the way you lost, I got some old good news. You can get it back on today. Are y'all gonna pray? Yes, my brothers and sisters. You don't have to leave here this morning without the Lord's joy. God's joy is available to all who is willing to accept him and to go along and to obey what he says. Yeah, sin the joy restored in his life. David was able to get the joy back. You see, in order for David to get his joy back, a prophet named Nathan had to confront David. When you read in 2 Samuel chapter 12, the Bible tells us that the Lord sent Nathan to David. And Nathan confronted David about the sins he had committed. About their sin. Yes, folk need to be confronted. They need to be told about the wrong that they have done. Yes, somebody ought to be concerned enough, ought to be Christian enough, ought to be godly enough to go to them and tell them, you've been wrong. That's what Nathan did to David. You see, it took a man. Walk up to the king and tell David, you done messed up, because he was the king. Are y'all listening to me? So just anybody couldn't do it. It had to be a man. And listen, God is still sending men. God still got some folk who will tell folk, you wrong. Jesus put it this way, how can wish you had a party too. How you just come talking to me? Did you go talk to that sheep? Are y'all with me? He didn't go through all that. He said, I have seen. You know why some folk can't get their job back? Because they're too prideful. They're too high up. They're too hard-headed to say, I have seen. You can't get your job back pointing the finger at somebody else.
Rejoice.
David said, look, beginning. I said, I don't want that to happen to me. And so I beg the Lord, Lord, please don't write me off. Don't throw me away. Please don't take your spirit away. Spirit. spirit ain't right, I'll cuss them back. Y'all ain't praying. If they hit me, I want to hit them back. So I need you to renew in me a right spirit so that my spirit won't be hypocrite. When Nathan told me about the rich man and the poor man, I was ready to judge the rich man because I had a hypocritical spirit. But when you give me a right spirit, rather than looking at him, I'll be able to see me. Lord, renew in me a right spirit. I got to hurry to a close. But not only he said, renew a right spirit within me, but he said, I need you to restore unto me the joy of thy salvation. In other words, I lost the joy. But nobody but you can give it back to me. Am I right about it? Now, joy is not something that comes back to you automatically. If you want your joy back, you got to ask the Lord to give it back to you. Am I right about it? Now, God is not the reason why we lose it. We lose it because of our disobedience. The joy of your salvation. When he said, it's the joy of thy salvation. Salvation is something to have joy about. And right now, salvation is a sure thing. Yeah. Salvation is eternal. Is something that never fails. Yeah, salvation is so powerful that it can save a lost soul and make them heaven bound. Am I right?
well. I got the clothes here. My brothers and sisters, I hear him saying, Lord, uphold me, because I can't make it by myself. Ain't God all right? Anybody here know he's able to hold you up so you can walk right? He can hold you up so you can talk right. Ain't God all right? He can hold you up so he can maintain your integrity. Ain't God all right? I got the clothes here, but he said, Lord, if you're creating me a clean heart, renewing me a right spirit, Lord, if you'll hold me up, yes, if you'll restore my joy. In verse 13 he says, then I'll be able to teach transgressors your ways, and I'll be able to convert sinners over to righteousness. Ain't God all right? He said, Lord, if you'll give me my joy back, I promise I'll do better. If you give me my joy back, yes, I'll go when you say go. I'll stay where you tell me to stay. If you give me my joy back, I'll tell somebody how good you've been. Give me my joy back. I can feel your presence when I lift up your name. Everywhere I go, I know you are with me. Give me my joy back. Ain't God all right? Anybody know he will? Anybody here know he's able to give it back to you? Somebody here need to testify. He gave me another chance, and I made up in my mind, I'm gonna shout, I'm gonna testify, I'm gonna live for him, because he gave me another chance. Yeah. Oh, good God Almighty. I got the clothes here. Oh, some of us in here, we can write our own book, and the book could be called Another Chance. Ain't God all right? You can write your own story, how God gave you another chance. It didn't work out 10 years ago for me, but God gave me another chance. Lost a good job and benefits, but God gave me another chance. I messed up over here, messed up over there, but God gave me another chance. I got locked up, had to spend some time away, but God gave me another chance. I was sick a long time, didn't look like I'd get over it, but God gave me another chance. And one while I was about to lose my mind, but God gave me another chance. Won't he do it? Anybody know he will? Yeah! Oh, yeah! I know he will. I know he will. I know he will. You can get your joy back. Leave here today with the joy of the Lord. Won't he do it? Yeah!